my parents had a pretty eclectic taste in music, and that rubbed off on my brother and I, in that my father was a classical nut. I mean, he worshipped Beethoven, and Beethoven was it. I never got into Beethoven. The only other things he listened to, apart from classical music, which I listened to on the radio all the time with him, was jazz, a certain amount of jazz, but different kinds. I mean, he liked Jelly Roll Morton. But he also liked Peggy Lee, who you wouldn't really think of as jazz. Then she was considered a pop singer. I know I could never sound like her, but I wanted to. You know, she swung like crazy, and to this day, swings more naturally, and it all sounds so effortless. Chicks were born to give you fever, be it Fahrenheit or centigrade, to give you fever. But I also was very influenced by my brother, who was passionately in love with Carmen Miranda and kept drawing her shoes. He loved platform shoes. I don't know whether he wears them still, but he really, really did good drawings of them.
I expect you're very, very proud of your brother, Bruce Springsteen, aren't you?
What?
Bruce Springsteen, your brother.
My own brother, Thomas, hasn't been doing too badly at that particular line either. He's written a lot of songs, as you may know, for The Seekers, one for Anita Harris, even one for me at one time. Anyway, this song that I'd like to sing you now was in fact written when he was 9 years old, so it's world premiere, folks. I hope you like it. Here we go. I'd like to sing it for you now.
Oh, it ain't all honey and it ain't all jam. Walking round the houses with a big old clam. Oh, love me lots and not a bite to eat. Drapes in around on me poor old feet. My old man, if I could find him in 99, would give. Poor old me, I haven't got a key and I don't know where I live.
I believe from researchers that you actually went on tour with the Springboks.
I beg your pardon?
The Spring Box!
Well, there were influences, but we were pseudo-everything and we knew it. I mean, we just jumped up and down a lot and were cheerful, which was... There was a niche somewhere for cheerful people. And we were terribly out of tune. We just sang very fast and very cheerfully. And they gave us a TV series, would you believe? You know, we didn't have a record or anything, but that was the BBC for you. Are we my way?
Hello, everybody. We'd just like to say how very happy we are to be with you on our own program. Well, the first song was a Zulu War tune with Tom on the bongo drum, Tim on guitar, and I'm Dusty.
I know something about love. Gotta want it bad.
The exciters sort of got you by the throat.
Go out and get him.
So I first heard it briefly in New York. We had a stopover in New York, my first time ever. And I was going past a record shop, the Colony Record Shop, which was open until at least four, if not all night. And I just walked past. I mean, it was the thrill of being in New York, and it was nighttime, and the buildings were so huge. And it was like, who needed drugs? You know, it was just incredible. And I, out of the blue, come blasting out was, I know something about love. Come on, I did. That's it. That's what I want to do.
I know something about love.
It was like 3 o'clock in the morning. Wherever it is, Broadway or something or other. That's it. That's what I want to do. And we were going to Nashville to make a country album. So I, you know, took the scenic route to it.
And then you went solo, did you?
Yes, I did that.
Well done, Dusty.
Thanks.
We're all very, very proud of you.
Thanks.
You're an icon.
Oh, you make me cry. That's really
very
nice.
Nice. You're fabulous. We think you're fabulous.
I only know I never wanna let you go. Cause you started something, can't you see? That ever since we met, you had a hold on me. It happened.
a try. Go on, ask her.
We're just thinking, look, it would... Come here. It would just help the viewer at home if you put them on.
No. I honestly can't.
Just do it.
First of all,
just
I never wore them that way.
Just do it.
Them.
Just put them on.
And it's the wrong colour and the wrong shape.
Please.
No.
She doesn't
not
want
anymore.
Stop trying to make Dusty put these on.
I won't.
Stop it.
I didn't.
She doesn't want to. You don't want to put them on.
No.
Stop it.
I'm not going to do it.
Lula would.
I don't care.
It's your head. This was taken off your head in 1964. Of her success?
No, not remotely. I can't do that kind of thing. I mean, she has that great out quality. I can't do that kind of thing.
Is there possibly a game show for you in the pipeline?
That's a good idea.
I'd hope not.
That's a good idea, though.
No.
What would we call it? Dream Dusty Date?
No, I know. It needs to be something really, really plain, like Dusty with an exclamation mark. Do you see?
Dusty... ... question mark.
Oh, absolutely.
Says it all.
I can see the posters.